Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough, ready to finish off the other members of the GR Grass Fort. I most certainly am, so let's go in and check this place out. Oh, is it my turn already? James is so unreliable. I am Liz, of course. I am also a member of... I read that wrong. I am Liz, period. Of course, I am also a member of Team GR. I'm addressing Mint, the child-defying Team GR, correct? I suppose you're looking to battle Parker for a GR grass coin. Yeah, it's just it's a good chance of that. In order to get through to him, though, you'll need to defeat me. And let's duel. But I want to finish tending to these flowers. Okay. Battles come before begonias. I have special terms for dueling. I only fight against decks with grass as their only energy cards. That is my only condition. Up for a duel, Mint? If I say yes, stop right there! Is that energy that's not grass energy? Don't you listen to my terms? Your deck must only have grass energy. Make a deck with that restriction before trying to duel with me. Okay, so our deck may need a little work to fit in to her rules. And yes, we actually have to... Oh wait, actually, I should save that to... Because I'm improving the deck anyway, so I should overwrite my other nature deck. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so view deck, and whoops, okay, now what we gotta do is empty out everything that is not grass. And then we gotta build up a deck that is so grass powerful that no one will be able to stop it. No one! Anyway, I'm just kind of flip-flopping stuff around here. I'm probably just going to leave the trainer cards the same for the most part, because I'm kind of limited in the strategies that I can use this early in the game because of my lack of cards. So I think what I'm going to do is focus on colorless and grass Pokemon, specifically the Rattata and Raticate. Actually, I think I'm going to go with one of those Rattata along with this one. Well, actually, no. I'll go with that one because it's got the 20 bite, even though it's got less HP. I'm thinking I should Spearow and Dark Spearow just to give. Well, I was thinking just to give him a shot. I know I still have Hungry Snorlax in there, having a good time. But yeah, I think maybe I'll just leave it as is. Because I don't think I want to switch up the grass Pokemon that much. I think I'll just add in a... Actually, wait, I want to show you something. She really truly wants only grass energy, so if you were to put like a special energy card in there, like recycle energy... So we're going to go and save that. Yeah, I'm not going to save that to the record machine though, because we're just playing around. But yeah, if you try and battle her now, she'll be like, stop right there, and then say the same dialogue. Because, yeah, you can literally only have grass energy in your deck. But anyway, alright, so we're going to go and pop out that cycle. And I think we're going to pop in another bill. Probably. Like, get those bills back up there. Alright, that should be good, I think, for our duel. Ready? Oh, back so soon? I hope you've been well. Our king has entrusted me with the duty of guarding this room's door. Do you recall my terms for dueling? You may only use grass energy. If you put any other type of energy in your deck, I won't fight you. If you follow my wishes, are you prepared, Mint? I am prepared. What about your other dialogue? You need to gather plenty of grass energy if you want to fight. It's rather hard to come by energy on GR Island, though. I got lots of them on all those decks I got, but I hit decks that don't have grass energy, and I only grass energy! Okay. Enough with the dialogue, enough with the deck building. I had to show the deck building this time because it's literally a mechanic of this particular duel and whatnot, that they put you on the spot to make a deck specifically for this duel. They do this across the GR Island because... they want you to use all sorts of different cards. Walking Toxins deck is a go. And since we have the ability to use all these different cards, like, you don't have to just stick with one deck now. In fact, you're forced to use different sorts of decks. I can show all sorts of different strategies. But first, let's, hope that we get a better hand. let's go ahead. Going first. Super Energy removal. I'm definitely going to power up my sore there. Oh yes, oh yes, that's very good. That is very good. I mean, I don't have another basic, but the thing about it is, neither does she, and she still doesn't have... Oh no, I got Razor Leaf coming. Yeah, I can just Razor Leaf. I mean, that... I win. Okay, I'll give her another chance. Just like I did. GR number one. Oh, jeez. Oh, dear. It seems I've been bested. I'm sorry. I mean, we both only had one basic Pokemon, but I was in just such a better position. Let's see what we got here. Okay. I'm surprised. You have quite a lot of skill. Do I? Since you have defeated me, I shall open doors leading to Parker. Please wait just a moment. Daintily opening the doors. Go on ahead. You shouldn't leave Parker waiting. I have my own business here taking care of this flower garden. One more. You remember my special conditions for card battles? I won't battle you unless you follow the terms used for all challengers. I will duel only against decks that use grass as their only energy type. I am definitely still up for a battle. Good, good. I see your deck only has grass type energy cards. Wait, are you actually digging through my deck to look at my cards to plan against me? Anyway, nah, maybe she's got a deck scanner or something like that, like Yu-Gi-Oh! Or... Alright, I'm giving you another chance here. And, oh, oh, that's actually my only shot here. I was going to say I'll power up Snorlax on the sideline, but okay, I know I have no choice but to power up Snorlax as the active. I got plenty of basic, as you've seen, it's just, yeah. I can do that, and we are going to have a nibble. Alrighty. That food counter is on the hungry Snorlax. It loves its cherries, that's for sure. It loves to eat everything, that's for sure. You know that, and call it a turn. I mean, I guess I could have ate again, but I don't think I have to. It didn't do 50 damage to whatever she's got anyway, so... Ooh, the poison! The Snorlax is getting the poison treatment again. But don't worry, it's got 100 HP, so it'll take a while. Alright, I'm gonna go... pop that on Scyther. And... oops! Oh shoot, I made a mistake there. I should have attacked with Rollout there rather than... yeah, because I would have sped things up a little. Well, maybe that wasn't a mistake, because it is kind of handy to get Scyther powered up in a similar fashion to Hungry Snorlax. Eh, we'll see how things go. Maybe I'm jumping the gun here and just thinking that I made a mistake when I didn't, actually. I mean, who knows what the future of the decks are holding for us. Who knows? All I know is I need to attack with Snorlax. Alright, so let's go ahead and do the rollout. Just so oh, shoot! I smashed through the clicks. Oh, after I won so easily, now I'm gonna have trouble winning. Nah, actually, we should be okay. We have the Scyther here. And let's go ahead and do that. Swords Dance, let's go. Double power that slash attack a little bit later on. Hopefully the poison won't be a thing on that. Hopefully, hopefully. Good, good. Alright. And we are safe. Basic, please? Thank you. You read my mind, or read my request. Alright, so let's go ahead and slash. Now we'll be able to do 30 damage per turn. Now normally that Scyther I would power up with double colorless, like as a part of the strategy, but I'm not allowed to have that in this particular game. But Scyther's still not a bad critter to have, so... we are good to go, I think, unless she does an Ember attack. Okay. We're good. It's double damage for 20, but does she not have fires, or...? Let's go, Bill. Eradicate, yes. Eradicate will be useful for the future, and also another Rattata will be useful for the future. Also, that Scyther will be useful for the future. I think I should save the plus power. I probably should save the plus power. But yeah, she's got sort of like a two-tone combo deck here. It's kind of weird. She's using Charmander, even though she hates decks that only use... I mean, that doesn't use any... like, just grass energy. But yeah, but I'm thinking, like, maybe... I never considered this before, I'd have to look up her deck list later, that maybe she just has the Charmander that she can only do the scratch attack, you know? Because, you know, you need the fire for the Ember attack, and maybe she's just got the Charmander for the damage. But why doesn't she just use something like a Ponyta, which is two colorless for 20 damage? I think that would be a little bit more versatile for the damage output. I don't know. yeah, you can stare down my Scyther if you'd like to. We are back in semi-control of the game. I might want to. Let's use that, probably. Because the Dark Auerbach, yeah, requires two of the energy. So I'm thinking, discard, suck. That puts her back one turn behind me. And then, bites. Another thing about Raticate that I would like to do is power it up with double colorless energy, but really I've only gotten one double colorless energy in the boosters so far, so still kind of lacking in that regard. Alright, that's okay. There's more game to play through. As a matter of fact, we're probably only like through a third of the whole game, believe it or not. Probably even less than that. Anyway, I guess I'll just go for the bites. Keep nipping at that Auerbach, and hope for the best. Hopefully I'll be able to keep her down by energy removal or just by KOing stuff, you know? I'm gonna go for that Rattata. Let's go for the bite to finish it off, and there we go. Alright, Charmander. You seem to be her only hope now. And I have a plus power, but I wouldn't tell her that if I was playing her face-to-face. So that means I can technically knock it out in just two turns. Unless something happens to my hand. But I'm going to keep that as a surprise and just attack with a regular bite right now. Because if the opponent knows that you can knock it out on the next turn, they will do a switch. That is strategy 101. I mean, not that it matters, because I have Gust of Wind anyway, but... You know, just teaching you Pokemon 101. Might as well dump out my hand there, and then attack with a 30 power bite this time, thanks to the plus power. Alright, so either or, even if I had a bad opening start and maybe a bad decision with Hungry Snorlax, I still won. Eh, whatever then. You seem to have grown quite accustomed to my battle condition. Let's see what we got. Got this, Mr. Mime. Yes! Another good Magmar. Alright, let's call it a booster. If you'd like to play on the right terms again, please feel... Or, just feel free to stop by. No, please. No, please. There's no politeness. No, it's just... No, that was very polite, actually. And we got some bushes in the shape of GR for this room to commemorate themselves. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of restore our deck to the way it was before. So if you don't mind, I'm gonna cut ahead. Oh wait, actually that was the way it was like that. So, oh yeah, that's right, it was the colorless critters. Anyway, cutting. Actually, slight change of plans here. I'm gonna drop one bill, and I'm gonna go drop one defender as well. And this is a slight change of plans, besides the... I put the colorless back to the way we were with Hungry Snorlax, but here's what I'm going to try differently. Instead of Goldene and Seeking, I'm going to do Squirtle and the Wartortle as just a little bit of a change up here, basically. They got, yeah, those sorts of dealios going on there. And also, two versions of Wartortle are out in the field. But also, I've got something else for you here. I'm going to go two of these sorts of Magikarp because of the rapid evolution. One of those, because it's got the flail, just for a little bit of variety. Well, actually, you know what? I'm gonna do that and that. just whatever. And we're gonna go. Gyarados is regular, but also darker Gyarados. Ha ha ha! Ooh, ha ha ha! Okay. And actually, no. We're gonna just try that as is, like in a little experiment. And. Wait. Okay, it's selected. I don't know why I thought it wasn't selected for some reason. Just paranoia, maybe. Welcome to the Garden of Lights. I'm Parker, the GR leader of grass. Yes, I am indeed Parker, but... Wait, didn't you just... Never mind. But you are Mint, correct? I assume you're after my coveted GR grass coin. If that's the case, you must first challenge me to a battle and win. By the by, there are special rules when you duel here. Grass Pokemon are immune to sleep, poison, paralysis, and confusion. That may work in my favor. No status conditions at all. It's an amazing addition. Now that you're aware, shall we duel? You decline because you're paralyzed in fear for my rule, eh? Well, that's to be expected. Well, I guess you didn't hear what I said. That's to be expected. Rebuild your deck and return later. I'll still be waiting here for you. No need to rush or anything. Hey there, Mint. Welcome back to my garden. Isn't it exhilarating? Just standing there the whole time. Welcome back. Isn't it exhilarating to have a card battle when surrounded by nature? Grass Pokemon are always so energetic when in my garden. They're immune to poison, paralysis, sleep, and confusion here. In fact, they simply cannot get status conditions in duels here. That aside, shall we have a duel? If you manage to win, you'll win GR Grass Coin. Let's not play too quickly. We'll use 6 prize cards. Full-on duel versus super happy gardener guy. Let's go. Chlorophyll is the special rule. Yep, it's not the actual chlorophyll that powers up your Pokemon from the main series video games when your grass starters are low in health. It's this sort of chlorophyll which prevents all status conditions. We'll be okay. So, new music going on here, big boss, super happy boss. Parker does not have anything, so he's gotta reshuffle. I cannot check that Dark Vileplume for you. Too bad for now. well, that's not bad. That's actually a pretty good hand. It's like I'm always complaining about my starting hand, but I still end up winning for the most part. Now watch me lose just because I said that. Alright, I go first. And my... Oh no! So he's got Scyther, Oddish, and Squirtle. Sleep Powder, Poison Powder. Yep, does that exactly. And, oh boy. So he's got the Water Pokemon in case I'm using Fire. As I said, you could use your starter deck, but that's kind of like a counter to Fire. But, you know, you have your fighting Pokemon as well. But then he's got the Scyther to counter your fighting Pokemon. It's a pretty well-balanced deck. I'm surprised that he managed to pull the Scyther on the first turn. But we'll see how things go, because it's still going to take probably 2 turns at least to power up Scyther. Depending on double colorless, I don't know exactly what he has in his deck offhand. Again, it's just so hard to memorize all decks in the game, but I can show you how to deal with things as you go. So let's Razor Leaf that Scyther out of the battle on the next turn, and this, sorry, this turn, but well, that's not really, I mean, The Pokemon power, the Pollen Stench here, you can cause confusion, but yeah, you may also confuse your own Pokemon, so that might work in my own favor. And obviously I cannot stop that from happening because the special rule of the game is no grass issues whatsoever. You know, status conditions, and actually what I'm going to sneakily do is evolve over to Ivysaur just to ensure I've got a bunch of HP out on the field for preparations of the future. Pokemon Trader, probably gonna get Dark Vileplume, aren't you? Kangaskhan for... There it is, Dark Vileplume. It's kind of like his signature card. And you'll see here, Hay Fever, no trainer cards may be played at all. As long as it's in play. Uh-huh. That's a pretty powerful little power there you got. And 3 coins, 30 damage times number of heads. That could be a problem. That could be a problem, but hopefully things will work out okay. Actually, yeah, I have 70 HP, so 2 head flips wouldn't have been enough. He would have had to get all 3 head flips. Alright, so let's give a warm welcome to this beast here. Yeah, that's definitely something you might want to consider if you have a copy of that. But remember, it prevents you from playing trainer cards as well, so it's not just your opponent, it's you as well, so it's two-sided. But the thing is, the idea is you're supposed to plan ahead and set things up before you drop the Dark Vileplume. But anyway, I should probably knock... I should probably knock down the energy, but no, I can't! I just reflex. After I just said it and everything. Alright, let's get that Scyther going, and let's ensure that we can hopefully ensure that we can knock out that Dark Vile Plume on the next turn. Please, just one heads. Just one heads. I'm not asking for zero heads, okay? I'm not asking for too much. I just want one heads. Okay, so I kind of lucked out there in a way, but at the same time, maybe I didn't, because I'm gonna just put in Magikarp to stall otherwise for what turn, and then I would have Scyther powered up to finish the job. Alright, so let's go ahead and I should have leech seeded. I'm an idiot. Yeah, oh well, because I would have recovered one damage counter, but I think it's our Ivysaur is a goner. Oh, that's right, though. I was gonna say I think our Ivysaur is a goner anyway, because Squirtle is gonna attack with the shell. But no, he doesn't have energy. Oh, good to know, huh? So that means I should keep him down, and I should continue powering up Scyther, and then we should leech seed. Obviously, I would be 10 less HP at this point, but well, that was my own fault for jumping the gun. Alright, big boss. I've got my bosses out on the field now. What will you do about this? Actually, I should leech seed again. Even though I could knock it out with Vine Whip, I just want to recover some damage counters as long as I have the opportunity, because I know he's low on the energy, so I might as well. So I also got a gust of wind. Very nice. Yeah, leech seed. I'll see if I can fully heal Ivysaur. And Oddish is outa. Best of luck. Gloom is outa. My other Dark Vile Plume might be a coming. We'll see. I'm gonna go. First off, energy removal. That. And we're gonna put the grass energy on. Well, actually, no. None of them will really benefit from that. Could dump that, just, and then, you know, prepare for the Professor Oaking. Or should I hold on to super energy removal? I'm thinking I should just Professor Oak, because I always do that, like, hold on to cards for a while, when I could just get so many more options, when I could play Professor Oak, and, yeah. So I think I should... Oh. I think I should... Oh, that's right. I think I should, focus on doing that more often. Alright, so we're gonna go again with the leech seed strategy here to continue on the healing, and we'll see how things roll. Nothing! Wow! So I guess I'll just keep healing then, huh? Leech seed! I think this is the wisest course of action. I mean, yes, I could knock out stuff faster with Vine Whip, but I don't know if he's gonna get more bench Pokemon, and I'd rather have a fresh Ivysaur waiting in the wings in case I need it, you know? Although I do have another Ivysaur of this variety, but... so maybe, but, you know, I mean it's kind of nice to have two, let's put it that way. I think he's just having a lot of bad luck, like I was having in other duels. But, I mean, well, I don't know, he's just gonna draw a card now. Let's see how that turns out. And we'll see what the result is on the next turn, if you got a basic Pokemon. Oh, okay, that's right, I can't. Bench is full. Grass. Let's go put that on Venonat for future Venomoth. Uh-huh. Could do the Shifteroo, and now I will do the Vine Whipperoo. It's looking like I'm gonna win this game. I mean, he's got 6 prize cards versus my 2, and a full hand of stuff. Oh, he's powering up a double colorless. Yeah, so he does have that. I was right about that with this whole Scyther combo. Hey, when you see a Scyther, you've always got to take into account that they probably have a double colorless energy. In fact, a lot of decks use double colorless energy in general, but... Details. So anyway, Vine Whip! And hopefully we'll be able to knock out that Kangaskhan before it Comet Punches us. Unless he's going to attempt this retreat, but no, he's actually going to go for the Comet Punch. Probably trying to do as much damage as possible before it gets knocked out. Holy moly! Wow, 60 damage for the comet. That's above average. Average is 40, of course. But you mostly play this version of Kangaskhan for drawing cards, but yeah, I'm... Whew. I guess I'll do that in case of Venusaur. And Leech Seed. It's not going to matter because this Ivysaur is going to be KO'd on the next turn, I think, anyway. But I might as well, you know, just see, because I think that Skull Bash is going to double colorless, probably. Or maybe not, I don't know, we'll see. Or not. Oh. Couldn't I just, like, well, I could first do that, but I was like, couldn't I just, like, do something else with one of my bench Pokemon to speed up this victory? Do I have a plus? I don't think I had a plus power, no. Oh, man! Well, you know what, I'm gonna do this for the sake of Ivysaur's safety. And try and accelerate things here, like, just in case of potions and stuff like that. And is he sweating? He's sweating! Oh, there's the double colorless! I was right that he had one of those coming, at least, but Defender prevented the Ivysaur KO, which means I win-o. Actually, I'm kind of swimming in grass energy right now. Oh, I just realized something! I put my deck the way that it was, kind of before, but I didn't swap out! I don't have any water energy in my deck, yet I'm playing water Pokemon. I was at a more of a disadvantage than I thought. Holy Arceus. Oh no. I was like, where's my water energy? I keep getting grass energy. Didn't I put less than grass in my deck? But I did in my original build. And I still have that because of the special requirements in the other room. Oh, jeez. And I still won! I seem to have lost. Hey, he doesn't much mind it that much. Alright, I'll borrow your coin if you don't mind. Let's see what we have here. Dark Wartortle. I can play Dark Blastoise now that I have this. Slaparoo for cheap. And Mirror Shell. You could use Mirror Force. It's your... kind of plop out the damage that Wartortle got on the attack turn, so it's kind of a interesting thing, unless it gets, you know, yeah, kind of overwhelmed by stuff before, you can pull that off, but you probably will be able to pull that off. Yeah, it looks like the rest of this is a good, and another Rocket, because he's the big bad boss. I can now play Dark Charizard as well. Nail Flick 10 for 1. That looks pretty bad, right? Well, this is the thing that you're going to want to have. Flip a number of coins equal to the number of fire energy cards attached to Dark Charizard. But you discard a number of energy cards equal to the number of heads after using it. So be mindful of how many energy do you attach to Charizard. You probably only want to attach 2 or 3 to him at a time. Like, say, if the opponent's Pokemon is at 30 HP, you only want to attach the 2, because chances are you're going to get one of the 2 coin flips. You know, you average it out in your head before that. But if the opponent's Pokemon has above 50 HP, you're probably going to want to go for one more energy card to get one more coin flip and hope for 100. Or, you know, just have a bunch of coin flips, like, just a bunch of fire energy and guarantee you're doing 100, 150... per turn, but you know, you can only attach one fire energy card per turn, so you might not be able to set it up like that. If you can, though, you're gonna be pretty pleased with this Charizard. another Dark Muk. Frenzy, if it's confused, does 30 more damage. Combine that with Imakuni for the most powerful powerful attack in the game. Or, you know, just use Frenzied Attack first and hope you can attack on the next turn because of confusion. But details, that's the risk of the powerful Dark Rhyme, I guess you could say. It's probably too risky to use because it relies on coin flips for the confusion, other than the initial attack. Or, well, hopefully Imakuni and then just do it right away, and if it doesn't work, then you take 20 damage, you're down to 40 HP, then you can use it again until you're finally able to actually use it, possibly, because the chances of you getting tails that many times in a row is unlikely. You get what I'm saying here. You want to play to the probabilities, anyway. Dark Vaporeon, Bite, Whirlpool. Suck those energy cards. That means I could probably put in the Eevees in my water reserve, because I can put this plus Dark Vaporeon and suck more energy cards away if I wanted to, but it's kind of low on HP, so it's kind of a risk-reward in that sort of regard. Ponyta's got the Ember, you know that one, you know that one. Okay. Additionally, to show your victory, I must give you the GR Grass Coin. Okay, so I'm not borrowing it, I'm taking it! No, actually, he gave it to me as a gift for victory. Woo! With that coin, you'll be allowed to enter the GR Electric Fortress. Remember that from earlier? Come visit again if you ever like the battle in nature's magnificence. Behold! Behold! But I still have not even showed the Alakazam coins. Maybe I'll switch to that for now and then switch to the gold bat later on. But for now, I'm going to end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part when I put those water energy cards back in my nature deck. Holy Mother of Arceus, that was embarrassing, I tell you.